everyone. Welcome to episode number 48. Thank you for your patience. We are back with an episode today, and we also are doing one in the month of December. So just so you know, our planned schedule. I have a huge answer to prayer that I want to share with you all. I got COVID a little over 3 weeks ago. And as many of you know, my mom and I live in the same house, and the Lord just protected my mom from coming down with it. So we are very thankful that the Lord protected her. And so anyways, just had to share that answer to prayer. We're past it. I'm through it. I've tested negative. But just thankful that my mom didn't get it. So we are back with an episode today, and the topic is on titled A Mother's Words Are Powerful. So turn it over to Mom to share her wisdom today.
Okay. I was thinking this week about an incident that happened when I was 7 years old, and I know exactly where I was standing, and like sometimes young people had freckles, I did. And a boy walked past me and looked at me and called me Freckle Face. You know, that was 65 years ago, and I still remember exactly where I was. You know, words can sting. And I'm sure all of you can think of words that do sting or that remind you of a painful memory. And so we're going to talk about our words today. I've often, and I think you probably have too, cringed when a mother out maybe at the park or shopping or whatever starts yelling and name-calling her child in public. And you know, that's a painful thing to hear, because a mother shouldn't do that at any time, but in public is especially embarrassing for the child. And you know, what would motivate a mother to shame her child in public like that? Well, it may be that she just never has been taught how to train your child in a positive way. And maybe she's just embarrassed the way the child's acting and wants to kind of make it all on the child and not on her lack of training. She might be frustrated. She might be, maybe has a couple of children or two or three that she's tried to steer through a store, and they're asking for things, and so she doesn't know how to handle it and gets frustrated. Or she might be just really tired and overwhelmed. And so those things really do contribute to being more likely to not respond in a good way. Now, a mom can also chisel away at her child's confidence in the home. You know, she might have misplaced priorities. Maybe she wants to be out with her friends, or maybe she wants to get decorate the house, or all these things can children still need to have a mom, and it may be difficult at that time. And maybe as a mom has the false notion that it's better to respond in anger to your child than to do any kind of a really controlled and discipline. So the Bible says a soft answer turns away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger. That's in Proverbs chapter 15, verse 1. Now, the mother that isn't good at controlling her own emotions and just lashes out when she's upset or contradicted is another thing that can cause a child to lose confidence or be afraid or discouraged. Also, a mother can be selfish. She might just want to do her own thing and doesn't want to be bothered with children. And as we talked about in some of the earlier episodes, there's ways that you can train a child to be occupied by themselves, and how you can gently encourage that in even very young children. Also, sometimes a mother will be out with other people and her friends, and with her children within earshot, can be complaining about her children. And that is not loyal, and that's not helpful, and it's discouraging for the children to hear that. Also, a mother can focus on the inconveniences and sacrifices she has to make to mother her children, rather than the high and holy calling of being a mother. So those are some things that can wear down a child's feeling of self-confidence and their joy. And so we want you to be, all of us examine ourselves and see if there's anything like that that we are doing. Now, the Bible says that in Proverbs 16:23, the heart of a wise teaches her mouth and adds learning to her lips. Now, in the Proverbs, it's his, but since I'm talking to ladies, I kind of made it more personal to us. You know, how can a mother train herself to consistently use her words in a wholesome and beneficial way? You know, sometimes mothers say, I don't know why I blurted that out. I feel bad about it now. But once words are out, they're out. And it's hard to take them back. And if you have done that, you need to acknowledge it to your children and say, that was wrong of me. You don't want to be a bad example of how to use words in a hurtful way. Our Lord tells us where our words originate, and it comes from our heart. And the word heart in Scripture, in the verses that we're using right now today, is that it is our thoughts and feelings. And if we're thinking negative thoughts, if we're frustrated, if we're disappointed, if we're have unfulfilled expectations or just feeling hopeless, you know, if we keep thinking those thoughts, it's going to come out in our words and the way we say our words. So it's very important for us to consider this seedbed of our words, which is our heart. Luke 6:45 says, a good man out of the good treasure of his heart brings forth that which is good, and the Greek word in there is beneficial. And an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart brings forth that which is evil. For out of the abundance of the heart, his mouth speaks. So whatever you've been nurturing, what thoughts, you know, it's real easy to have thoughts that are kind of like deer trails. If you've ever lived in the mountains or gone on hikes, sometimes you'll see these trails on a hillside, because deer choose to go someplace that they're used to going, and other deer will find it and follow that trail too. So if we have thoughts that we regularly think, where we're feeling sorry for ourselves, where it's leading to bitterness against someone, those are like deer trails, and it's very easy to keep thinking those things. Because the more you think of it, the more you're convinced that it's true. So we've got to be careful about that and really think about it. I think one thing that we should pray daily is Psalm 19:14. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. So it's when we confess our negative thoughts and our thoughts that don't lead toward faith and God and obedience to Him, it's good to start turning a corner. And I love that where it ends with, my strength and my redeemer. God, through His Holy Spirit, will give you the strength to confront and confess the wrong thoughts and to ask Him for His grace and love to be able to speak in a way that is beneficial. We've been talking about not doing the negative. Let's talk about the positive. And before we talk about the positive, you know, some of us might consistently praise our children in ways that are not helpful. An example of that would be praising them for their outward beauty. But our current culture loves to put the emphasis on making girls think of themselves as princesses and our boys as superheroes. And, you know, it's good to have help your son to be able to use his strength in a way that is beneficial. But we don't want to have them do it just to focus on themselves, but to be a help to others. Proverbs 22:1-4 says, "But God says, a good name is rather to be chosen than great riches, and loving favor rather than silver and gold." And the verse 4 says, "By humility and the fear of the Lord are riches and honor and life." So we want to praise the qualities that give them a good name and that honor the Lord. So it is far better to praise them for things like this, for kindness, when they're showing kindness and taking time to do something thoughtful. Unselfishness. It's easy for a young child to just really grab on their own toys and not willing to share. But when they start being willing to share, and you can notice that and commend them for that. Quick obedience is another thing. Faithful in their chores. Truthful. Respectful. Patient. Lots of times it's hard for children to be patient. And so acknowledge that when they are patient. Good manners. And also gentle with animals and younger children. So those are some things that are character issues. They're virtues. And we want to encourage those. Now, another thing that'll help with your children is, you know, children grow in self-confidence when they learn new skills. And so when you're helping your child maybe learn to read or learn skills that are working with wood or lots of things. Now, teenagers, we've talked about skills like that in earlier episodes and all. But when you can see a child really pursue and work hard at a skill, and when they reach the goal, that's something worth acknowledging and making, just praising them for, not being discouraged. Also, do not compare your children with his or her siblings, because every child is different and will excel in another area. Acknowledge each child as a unique individual that God created with specific skills that He has designed for that child's future and well-being. So just some thoughts on words. We're thinking about words today, and I want you to be thinking about it through the week and taking stock. Are there thought patterns that are causing you to not be always gracious with your words? Confess those and ask the Lord to help you with the words of your mouth and your meditations of your heart. And this can apply also to the words that you say to your husband. And it's not just the words themselves, it's the attitude that you say it with. So be a virtuous woman. The law of kindness is in her heart, as said on Proverbs 31. And that, you know, a law is a law. You don't want to break the law. And that law of kindness is something that your husband and your children should hear from you.
All right. And we don't have a topic picked out for next time, but just know it'll be about another month before our next episode goes up. So we'll see you again in December. And we appreciate you taking the time to watch this video, and we trust that it was an encouragement for you and that you'll share it with someone who you know would be encouraged as well. So thank you again, and we'll see you next time.
So long.
Bye.